Guess what we're playing? That's right, Doom.
Almost.
Rise and shine, Mr. Freeman. Rise and shine.
Was this guy also in...
Try this shit, it's awesome.
Was this guy in the first Half-Life as well?
Oh yes, it was like from the beginning.
Oh, no, he
gives you a speech halfway through, I think. Until, but he definitely shows up at the end and gives a similar speech.
Oh yeah. Just say we should also note that we are not playing the game currently.
Due to one thing or another, holes in space and time, various things. I mean, nothing to do with that lawsuit. That woman is a liar. we're short on time, so we're playing the game first. And then just talking over it afterwards.
Exactly. Why not? And I also, for the record, I recorded this.
Yes.
And it's gonna. Record, you're gonna notice.
For the record, I definitely did not.
It's gonna be clear.
I've seen a little bit of this footage, and to say the least, I am unimpressed.
You have not seen half of it.
No. And I am not going to hold back. My friend.
Me neither. Me neither. This is a riff track, if anything.
End of the line. I guess we'll never hear that guy's voice again unless he voices 50 other people that are totally different but sound exactly the same.
Oh, yeah. Man, those...
this guy's in the first one as well.
Oh, okay.
For a time, I think. Let's take a little moment to just actually appreciate that this is... for the time, a beautiful game.
Oh yeah, this is, by the way, the Half-Life 2 update version.
Yes, it wasn't this sexy and shiny.
But it's great for its time.
Yeah,
still,
when I played it first week,
they put something in it to make you forget.
They pissed in it. Breen personally pisses in every bottle. It's wasn't this perfect when it came out, and it, especially since my PC back then was not perfect either.
Yeah.
Actually, that might be a good. What system did you play this on? I mean, I know you've not got the world's best rig possible, but it's pretty admirable.
Last year it was high end.
Oh, it is high end.
Yeah, it is high end. NVIDIA 970 TX something or another.
I lost track of anything.
Yeah, but I think there's just one.
Years ago.
There's just the 1080 or something is the latest one. I think it's slightly. It can handle VR. That's pretty good.
CPU, for example. What you got running there?
I don't remember. That would have been good to know.
People just don't care about that shit anymore, do they? No.
It's good.
Few people anyway. Like, is it even Intel or AMD or what?
Intel sounds familiar.
Okay. But the thing is, now it's hard to know because it's just codes.
Yeah.
Back in the day. Sorry for the scare. I had to put on a show. This guy's in the original as well. But
yeah,
not
I imagine.
Long, I think.
But I had never seen him. I had no. I wished I played the first one before this one.
Yeah.
No one loves that. We'll come back to that.
The back in the day, it was like, what have you got? I've got a Pentium 2. Oh, I've got a Pentium 3.
That makes sense.
Like, yeah, and there was gaps in the middle where everyone had a Pentium 3. And, like, did you have a Pentium 3 300 or a Pentium 450? And guess what? The 450 was 150 better than the 300. and you could tell. So when I played this...
Yeah?
I played it on a custom build. It was an Athlon. I'm going to say... Now, this sounds, for the time, a very poor system. The CPU was actually a mobile 2500, which, thanks to copyright shit, they couldn't call it a 2.5 gig. But I think it wasn't even that. It was a very cheap, very potentially slow mobile laptop CPU in a desktop.
Okay.
that had a flaw in it from the factory, and I had to buy a special serial, like from a special, what's it called? Like a batch
yeah.
On the line that was in a specific serial number area.
Yeah.
And if you had that and the right RAM and the right motherboard with the overclocking capacity, I could take this, like, it was like, meant to be 1 point something when it was in the laptop.
Yeah.
Because back in the day, you used to build your own laptops, apparently.
Laptops, even.
Oh, yeah, when they were called that.
Yeah.
And, oh, wait, is this where you, like, was that, did I just talk over you not finding the box for 10 minutes there?
Yeah. Enough 10 minutes. Yeah, it's going to be more, it's going to be literally 10 minutes. Not.
Oh, no, I'm thinking that it's worse on the later one.
Oh, yeah, and that's not, that's more like 15 minutes.
Okay, so the one I'm thinking of might even be.
Oh, yeah, it's coming. Don't you worry.
But yeah, this is this cheap little Athlon, which AMD were definitely the second class citizen of CPUs back then.
Mm.
And like now, where I think they've just released something that's like the saving grace of PC gaming or something.
Yeah, so I've heard as well.
This was, it should be 1.8, if I remember rightly, 1.8 gig. In 2000 and, when is this, 6, 5, something like that?
This game was released in 2004.
Oh, 4, okay. So in 2004, I had a 1.8 mobile CPU, so it was also slightly underclocked for heat purposes. But there was a mistake in the manufacturing, which basically made it the same, very tolerant to heat.
Yeah.
So you could overclock it to be the same. I got it up to 4 gigahertz, but it was boiling. And I wouldn't run it for very long. And like sometimes I managed to boot it, but after like 15 seconds, it just crashed. But it would boot.
Oh, okay.
But the temperature, like we had extra stuff, and we were in an air-conditioned room in an college.
Yeah.
But I kept it regularly at 3.5 gigahertz in 2004.
That sounds incredible.
With a massive, massive 4 gigabytes of RAM.
Yeah, that's got to be massive.
I mean,
back
I
then.
Don't totally have a computer somewhere slightly behind me with 32 in it, and that's not even full yet. graphics card, I don't truly recall. Something like a 9800 something, but it was the pro version. That might have been NVIDIA. Yeah, NVIDIA GeForce something. And I still couldn't run it at full settings.
Yeah. What are we going to do? But yeah,
but nowadays, if I sat down and thought about it properly, I could remember every stat.
Yeah, probably, yeah.
But now, nobody cares as long as it's fast.
Yeah, exactly.
As long as it costs a lot, it's probably good.
Yeah, that's what I thought when I bought it.
That was what I loved about my little bastardized thing. It was cheap and a total fucking hack. I had a copper CPU heatsink on that was the size of a small child's head.
Here, a long series of actions.
You see, I was really disturbed by the sort of totalitarianism in this, but now it's just a slight message of future America.
Oh, yeah.
But we'll not get too political on this, but yeah, this is basically half Trump.
Okay. Let's go there. Let's stick our shins out.
Well, come on. At this point, it's not even an exaggerating joke. At this point, it's...
I don't have...
You're just commentating generally on how it's going by mentioning things like that.
Oh, I'm so nervous. I know there's soon coming things up that I get embarrassingly stuck at. Why the goddamn machine? Let's go on a rant here for a second.
Go on.
Why the goddamn Steam achievement? What they just come up at random.
But this is the end of the intro almost. Now you're gonna get the cutscene.
Oh, that's another. But Steam in general, play Steam. I don't want achievement things popping up in the bottom right because I don't know what they are for. The achievement doesn't explain what I have achieved.
They're for people that don't care about anything else. Hurry. People that have there's a lot of people out there.
There's probably a way to turn them off, but fuck
yeah, it's tab and then I think there's one button. one.
Probably.
I don't think it occurred to him that you might not have a map.
I'm perfectly animated. there was a big bug in this when it released that, just as you were like getting excited, like, oh wow, a female has arrived in gaming, that, especially at that age. And like, oh, she's into me. This is hot. It crashed just there.
Oh,
a lot of people. It was called the lift bug or something. and you had to spend hours downloading a fucking patch over dial-up to. I did. We had broadband very late because I lived out in the sticks.
Hours is, by the way, the amount of cutscene time this game has. well, talking dialogue time at least.
Yeah, unloading time. This would take. Oh yeah. This used to take so much longer.
Oh yeah, I can imagine.
Especially on shitty hard drives.
Yeah.
so the animation seems so bad now.
Oh yeah.
But this was like, whoa. It's like being there. yeah. I feel part of the team. It's a dangerous route. You seem to be looking down a lot there, fella.
My eyes are.
Have you seen the mods for her?
I can imagine, though. My,
it's like you've suddenly arrived at that Matrix dungeon on one of them. She looks like a hooker in some of the... supposedly, all we've done is increased the resolution of some textures and, you know, improved some of the models to make them more realistic. No, you haven't. You've turned her into a sex dungeon mistress or something.
Another achievement. I didn't achieve anything. I played the game as intended. That can't be an achievement.
Remember this when we're editing later. I have a picture to send you. In fact, while I'm chatting, he's in the first one. Oh, do you know what his joke is?
No?
I say things that are confusing and then make a mistake, but then I fix it. That's his jokes.
Yeah, okay.
Oh no, science has gone wrong.
We owe a great deal. That's also, but I have no, they don't even try to explain what the fuck I did in the first game.
The first one, very roughly, is they're doing an experiment to, I think, to like make energy or something.
Is the world totalitarian?
No.
Okay.
We created it by accident.
Oh.
Well, we didn't create it. We witnessed it as we were joining the project.
Oh.
There's a lot of people that all sound like him and look like him because apparently they could only have three models.
is that the Black Mesa project?
Yeah.
Okay. This is a red letter day. We'll
inaugurate the new teleport. And they make this whirly gig thing that spins around. Makes. I think it was meant to make energy.
Yeah.
Generate power in some way. And it opened a wormhole to this other dimension full of asshole aliens. And there, it's them over.
Oh! Yeah.
And you're fighting your way out of the laboratory to get to the surface.
Oh!
And then eventually, I think you actually end up in the other dimension and then come back.
That sounds awesome.
That's good to a point, but I think it drags off on the end.
Okay.
Like when you're in this other dimension, it's like the physics change a bit and it gets a bit hoppy. Now, this thing. The first time I ever met my now mother-in-law, we went out for pizza. And when we went out for pizza, she ordered a calzone. You know what a calzone is?
Yeah.
Where they basically get a pizza and then put another pizza on, or like they take half the pizza and turn it into a pizza ball, basically.
Yeah.
And when hers arrived, it disappeared from my photo library, so I can't see it anymore.
Well then.
That's good.
But it reminds you of
When it arrived, they'd clearly done some weird thing where they'd bun the ends around, and so when you cook it, it fills with air as well.
Yeah.
And so it looks like almost like egg shaped.
Yeah.
With normally it just looks like egg shaped, and there's little bits of crust on the side.
Yeah.
But this one in particular.
Oh my God!
Just exactly that. Actually, this isn't the original photo. I took a photo with it on my original iPhone, the iPhone first one.
Yeah.
And so because of that, A, I've no idea where the hell that fucking photo is. It's somewhere on Twitter in the past, maybe.
I've
modified your suit to draw power from combine. But because it's also the first iPhone, it looks like ass. Because it was in a darkly lit London restaurant.
Oh.
But I googled it and found one other photo from one other guy somewhere that had the same thought and tweeted it.
Oh.
And so that is what this is that you're probably seeing on the screen now. I don't smoke, but this one looks possibly even better. But the one that she had also had back legs for some reason or somehow.
Gordon,
why don't you position yourself here? And so she ate a head crab in front of me. It was fantastic. Yes, yes.
That is incredible. That's also someone from first game, I guess.
The problem with this game is, and it would be even harder if we were actually playing it. So it's why it's why I thought this wouldn't be a good one.
Yeah,
story is actually good.
Yeah. Yeah, I found the story awesome. Would be even interesting if I knew what the fuck happened before it.
But that was a nice thing. You didn't need to know, but it was intriguing.
Yeah, it was a little slightly. Oh, hey, you again.
But the graphics, unless you play the updated Black Mesa remake.
Oh, yeah.
What happened to that cat? Oh, no, something's gone wrong with science again. I'm going to... Oh, will our new physics engine somehow fix this problem? Yeah, don't just want to show it off. Oh, it did. Good, good.
This is an insane engine they built.
Oh, yeah.
You know, that struck me really during the play. How many different things you can do. It is insane. I understand why so many things are based on it.
It's what it was, why it was so mind-blowing at the time, because before this it was like... I didn't play a lot of first-person. What did I play that was similar? I think the only thing I played to this before this similarly would have been Unreal Tournament 2004.
Oh yeah, I played that a lot.
Oh, I really want to set up a couple of PCs, like old ones.
Yeah.
And record a LAN of that.
That would be incredible. Well, I can take. Well modded as well. I've mods for that.
Here's a good one. I was at college at the time of this, sort of the equivalent of your gymnasiet. And what was it? It was like an IT course, basically, only. Basically, you fill up a room full of computer geeks.
Yeah.
We basically just merged into this one game-playing beast.
Yeah.
We formed a little clan playing Unreal Tournament 2004. And we made our own modded character models.
Oh,
in like
shit.
A team. And we were the Badger Rangers.
Oh, that's...
So we looked like the Badgers from the Badger cartoon.
Yeah.
But we all had a different color. Like the Power Rangers.
Yeah.
And we were all assigned a different color, basically based... we picked a color, but every color almost matched how we played as well.
Mm-hmm.
My friend, I think it was Ben, was the black badger.
Yeah.
Not because he was black, but because he always played sniper.
Yeah.
And he was always very much a camper. Well, not always, but it helped in that because he was the black one, which was basically he was almost invisible.
Oh,
he was black with dark
gray
stripes, and he would hide in the shadows, and you could barely see him. But he had these to make it not to make it give people a chance and to make it not a cheat.
Yeah,
he had these glowing red eyes, which was pretty epic.
Yeah,
and even though there isn't an official Power Ranger with this color, it just matched my style.
Yeah,
I was the brown badger.
The brown badger.
Yeah. Because I think the only ones left was like fucking pink, somebody else took green. I think it was blue or pink.
Yeah.
I didn't fancy being fluorescent blue or pink. It looked too cartoony or silly, even though it's a cartoon fucking badger.
Yeah.
But no, brown suited me.
Okay.
Brown. Yep, brown.
Okay, and who played the yellow? Who was there, a yellow badger?
I think there was a yellow badger. Hey, yeah. Gordon. No, he wasn't black, if that's what you're looking for.
No, thought more Asian, like maybe. Get out of City yellow.
As fast as you can, Gordon. Oh, yeah, I thought
that because was... Because the, that was the thing at Power Rangers.
Oh, yeah, of course. They were, like, very, very... They weren't even subtle with the fucking...
Yeah, the black one was black and the yellow one was Asian. Yeah.
You know, that's the reason for the Olympic rings. Each one represents a continent, and the color of that continent. Africa is black, Asia is yellow. It's
what?
The same thing, yeah.
How is that not a huge thing that's being debated? Well, what in achievement? I got
The crowbar's the thing. Crowbar. That's in the first one.
Yeah, what an achievement to get the crowbar. Oh, I have achieved something.
A lot of those, I think, are ironic. There's a lot of ironic humor around Half-Life.
Okay, I hope so. But
now, is this the music kick in here?
Yeah?
Yeah, I when I was playing it, I was definitely... This was the music of the time.
yeah. The prodigy.
It was the done thing of the day. But I was like totally not into this fucking drum and bass.
Yeah.
You know, small box, little box, cardboard.
No, oh, I was so close!
Yeah, oh no, that I didn't see this.
I was so close!
I fast forwarded past this because I hate this music so much.
Oh.
I had a preview at it.
I missed it! I was so close! This is gonna be frustrating to watch knowing where to go.
So no, I didn't like this sort of gay club music.
Yeah, yeah.
First thing I did was stop it, pause it, go to the settings, turn off the music, and I had the rest of it without any music at all. But the thing is, so all I know is this Big Fish, Little Fish, Cardboard Box type song.
Yeah.
I've heard nothing else, so I'm guessing it must change tone a lot later on.
Oh, yeah. A lot. I love music. I didn't think of this too much. I don't mind this kind of music at all, really.
Because I was playing it on some big headphones and had it turned quite up high up for the sound effects. And
yeah.
The music kicked in. And I was like, took me out of it because I was thinking I felt like it was an 80s sci-fi in my head.
Oh.
And then suddenly this sort of 90s pop. Music,
yeah,
kids and pop music. it didn't suit the tone for me.
Yeah, okay, yeah, I guess. Yeah,
it was also much more atmospheric, is the word my tongue just couldn't quite get to.
Yeah, there we go.
A
riveting combat.
and I think actually some of the environmental sounds still got through.
Oh, okay.
I think that bit wouldn't have counted as music. And there's still the droning in the background.
Yeah,
and stuff.
Yeah.
It's just you don't get the action music at some points.
Alright.
Like, triggered when you walk into a certain room or something.
Yeah. Now, this should really say itself, but man, is the gunplay good.
Oh, yeah. So much freaking fun with that.
Yeah,
thing.
It's probably the best gunplay I've ever had in a game.
I mean,
it's more
exactly
or less
the same as CS. What was the last one before Go?
Source?
So, yeah, of course. Yeah. Source. CSS. That's what we call it.
Was it the 1.6?
No. That's Counter-Strike 1.
Oh. I've never got 1.6. Into Counter-Strike for the record. Just to...
No, I've played 1.6 a little bit after playing Source.
Yeah.
And I bought Go just to try it out. And it's okay, but because I started on... I mean, it came free with this when I bought it. So I tried it out and played a lot of evenings of that with the Badger Rangers, in fact.
Yeah. I've played a few games of Counter-Strike in my later days, like a year ago I played for the first time or something.
Source or Go or 1.6?
Source, that's the latest one, right?
No, Go is the latest
one. Oh, then it was Go.
Go, it's almost like... it's when you overdo a cake.
But it was not the game, it was the other players.
Oh god, no, I never played it with... I hated playing it with other normal people.
But they weren't normal people, they were monsters.
And that's the thing, in the new one, it's harder to play a private game.
Ah.
But what we did is, we got our little TeamSpeak server.
Yeah.
We We used basically the person that had the best broadband as the server and hosting it, and then everyone would have agreed to turn on the computer at the same time.
And
we'd all just type in his IP address. And then we'd have a private match without any assholes in it.
That sounds wonderful.
That's fun.
Yeah, I can imagine.
If we're a bit low on numbers, fill it with some medium range bots, or what was fun sometimes is playing around with the bot settings. Like, you could set them really...
Jump over the fence!
Oh, yeah, I
idiot.
Love this one.
Oh,
yeah,
continue. Sorry.
You play around with the bot settings, so you can make them really hardcore accurate.
Oh.
But only with a knife. So then the game turned into make sure that you stay away from the other team's bots. But as long as you, you know, it's cool. As long as you just keep. Oh God, I remember this.
Continue.
I remember seeing this. That and think, oh bless his little cotton socks. You can hit it with your stick. You've hit so many of the boxes with sticks so far. What stopped you there?
Yeah, it's gonna be harder than I thought.
I think it's like a de-evolution of how games are now.
Yeah.
So you're expecting things that are now tropes. Before this became some earlier trope. But it became a game of stay away from the bots, because if you get too close, they will instantly kill you with a knife.
Jeez.
But as long as you keep your distance, it's okay.
Ah. I just compare it to... played another FPS a lot, Fallout, in New Vegas. The gunplay is so shit compared to this. I can imagine if every game had this kind of gunplay. You can actually hit stuff from far away. That's impossible in most other FPS-like games I've played.
Yeah, this
impossible.
This is an interesting blend of extremely generous with the aim. Like, there's a little bit of auto aim on this.
Oh yeah.
Like, you can tell.
Yeah, definitely.
But also, it gives you a lot of accuracy on certain things at a distance that you have to really try for.
Yeah.
So it's a nice little plan. Like, it's stuff up close, you just want it easy anyway.
Yeah.
But if stuff's far away, you've got to be more accurate. Now, I think my favorite bit of the... I stopped watching slightly after this. Slightly after the bit that we were talking about, the bit that you took ages here, I think.
Yeah, somewhere. It's getting close. But there's a lot of them. We can't keep track of every
But I especially place. Liked this one, because you even stare at it for a moment.
Oh.
Okay. Jesus. How do you get over the red box?
Okay, so I've been taught by the game to stack things
okay,
first.
This is you where I'm not going to be an idiot like the last one.
Yeah.
I'm going to use the things I've learned.
Yep, exactly. The game have taught me.
I definitely won't investigate any of the sides in detail. I mean, I'll have a quick shifty at this one. That's interesting. And, only a ladder here. That might have been...
Oh no! It isn't this one. I know which one.
But
I
you
think
still
you
took you a bloody long time.
Oh yeah. There's
these things. That alien is a villain in the first one.
What?
And I didn't get that when I was playing it, because I saw them. I was like, oh, my friends are here, and then they zapped me to death.
Oh. Well, this confused me as well. Oh, there's aliens here, I guess. Okay. They're friendly.
They came from the other dimension, but now they're friendly. This is always confusing.
How about mention that?
I'm not entirely sure why. I think they were enslaved by somebody.
That is all we can spare.
That's the best I can get.
Be careful now.
But really, can't afford to get noticed. Couldn't they fit that in the earlier exposition? That earlier aliens exist now here.
Yeah,
because that blew me the hell off.
It didn't blow you off, it blew you away.
No, it didn't blow me away. There's another expression. I'm so close. It didn't blow me off, of course. Or did it?
No. Oh, come on. I I'm sorry. I'm having a little flashback to I hated how many that took for me. I was not actually here to you. It was just me having a little moment.
Oh, okay.
It was like, I remember, I think I hit that a couple of times and had a thing. I was like, it's not breaking up, but it takes a few hits. These are in the first one, I believe. They're called barnacles.
The first time I played, because I played this 2 years ago, the very first time, and I got stuck at the point that's coming up and never passed it. But the first time I got caught in one of those tongue things.
Barnacles. Yeah.
That scared me the fuck off. And I said, what the fuck is happening? I'm going up. I look up and I see that mouth there.
That's good.
A lot of this game, especially later, is me just panicking. Completely panicking. And not being able to handle a situation.
So, somebody who can't handle 3D images on a flat screen. Oh, why did you buy an Oculus again?
Sound effects.
So now I'm terrified and I'm puking myself with travel sickness. Oh,
and come on, up the ladder. There you go.
Actually, you know what? The ladder physics in this are famously iffy.
Well, they are very weird. You just run up the ladder.
But it's like tricky to jump. To do fancy stuff with it later.
That confused me as well. Am I holding it? Apparently.
Yeah, I suppose it's a bit weird. But at least it's not the fucking Halo thing where you suddenly go third person.
Oh, yeah.
Like it's a really vehicle.
And the helicopter is coming soon, right?
Yes, I think so.
I never got past the helicopter. It always. I think that's.
Or is it later? Isn't it later?
What is that?
That's a tank. It's a tank that comes first.
Right.
It's the barrel up there, isn't it? That you get rid of that.
Yeah, I think so.
I don't recall, and since I can't look around myself, it's confusing. Yeah, take that.
Well, those sound effects, puking sound effects, they are a completely different sample rate than everything else. They sound extremely low quality. Have you thought about that?
No, they might have just reused. No, I think they...
But it's some sort of weird stereo.
They're using a cheap filter, I think, to try and make it sound. There's a lot of...
It sounds
effects like when you're in a tunnel, they'll add a reverb that maybe isn't the world's best reverb because it's dynamically added. So it's like adding the reverb live.
Yeah. Okay.
So they're probably using a cheap but that's reverb that doesn't use a lot of CPU. Oh, it's so cheap. They're using a metal reverb, I think.
Now, even though I get stuck at places, I'm still sort of familiar with my playthrough 2 years ago. Ish, almost, even though it's hard to tell at some points. I'm still no...
Oh no, I remember the bit where I was talking about another time.
Yeah.
The bit that's coming up where you get well and truly stuck.
Yeah. What's the best way to handle that situation? I guess going up here. Oh, but that blows open, right? I can swear that wasn't open before they exploded. Oh well.
I think it was. It was just you couldn't get up it until something exploded.
Yeah. Very. Oh no! It was some sort of water fan that I got stuck on. That's coming. I never found the way after that, and just never played the game again until this playthrough. And I accidentally found the solution now. I should not have been able to find that solution.
It took a while though, didn't it?
It definitely did.
Sometimes I see you doing things, and like, you almost shot the barrel while you were next to it then.
Oh yeah, there's...
a few of those.
A less optimal playthrough.
Oh, okay. But I don't remember the last achievement popping up recently.
No, there's been very... I can't even remember if
achieving very little.
Yeah, exactly.
I love messing around with this the first time. Just playing with the barnacle, seeing what they eat.
Oh yeah, because I was so first time, because this I remember from the first time playing through. I should be able to do this, and then I felt really smart.
Yeah, I loved it.
But I think I forget to light it on now. Yeah.
Oh, you get to shoot it on the way up.
I forgot about that part.
Oh shit! But then they drop it.
I don't know. Yeah.
I did this once. It landed on its side and exploded as it hit the bottom.
Yeah, there's an achievement for you.
Yeah, well, what was that? Barrel...
Bottling? I don't know.
Barnacle... something.
Yeah.
Boxing? I think it's when you kill a lot of them in one go.
Probably. That's an actual achievement. That's something you won't guaranteely do on a playthrough. That's something you have to do
as an
extra.
Well, it's easy to accidentally do just there.
Okay. But it's not as easy as picking up the crowbar.
No. I'll... Oh!
Jesus, that was badly. And now ladder.
I love I love some of the physics are way over the top, like that. You're bouncing like you're made of polystyrene.
Oh yeah.
Hanging in the water. Humans do not do this. They do not jog through the water. It's deep, 5 times deeper than themselves. With their arm pointed forward the entire time.
Come on, can I do some plat?
Yeah. Yeah, there's some real platforming in this sometimes.
Oh yeah, I was not expecting that, really. This is a lot of it, especially later.
And when they start playing around with the physics and that, too.
Yeah.
I hated this. You know what? I will admit, this one, the first time, I was stuck.
Yes! I'm not an idiot.
No, I was... stuck as all hell on this, and I think I had to somehow, how did I do it? I think I watched a friend on its own computer do it. I was like, oh, you idiot. It was like super easy. I think I actually did try it.
Yeah.
I tried the solution, it just, because the physics are so sensitive, it just didn't work for me for some reason.
Oh, but you got that you laid the bricks on.
Yeah, I had to do something. I got the distance slightly wrong or something.
Yeah,
I'm used to, at this point, games working by you put things in a box.
Yeah.
And they just work regardless. But no, you have to get them sufficiently far away.
Yeah.
I got them touching each other too much, I think, and so they kept falling off as I got on.
Oh, yeah, they're going to fall off. A lot here, right?
And yeah, you literally have to get it in the right end because it's so sensitive.
Yeah, this is so. This is going to be so. Oh, there I got one on the far end. Because you think, I'm solving it. I'm doing this. Now it should work. It didn't work with three exactly, but now,
you're putting them too close to the center.
Yeah, now
they're. This is not how a lever works.
But I got it now, but then they fall off.
Or a lever.
What is the... Do people say lever?
In America, they do.
Oh.
Yeah, they go to the... Oh, I've gone through that one too many times. The whole laboratory...
Oh, yeah.
Laboratory thing.
So close!
Yeah, I think I did. That's how it worked for me. Although, for me also, it kept crashing because I was on shitty hardware.
Okay.
But after watching this a bit for a while now, I'm realizing something. Half-Life 2 isn't, not just in the fact that there's like crates everywhere, it's an incredibly boxy game.
Oh yeah.
It's still got that little bit of Quake boxiness. recently there has been some developments in the Half-Life 2, Half-Life 3 information.
Yeah.
Gabe Newell recently did an Ask Me Anything.
Oh, he
and
did?
Of course, most of the questions ended in a 3 question mark. And one of his replies was, "Thou shall not say the word 3.
Okay.
Is one of his replies. And I think it's like, he says something about like him. A lot of things that happened in Half-Life 2 are resulted in regret. So he regrets a lot of things about Half-Life 1 and 2.
Oh, okay.
Is
he a George Lucas on it?
No, I don't know. I think he'd totally be against that.
Yeah.
Although there are rumors of some kind of... He's done a deal with J.J. Abrams to make some movies.
Oh, okay. I have no clue.
That was like years ago and nothing's, but he says something, you know, keep an eye out, something will happen about that.
Yeah.
But there's no immediate plans for a Half-Life 3.
What?
No immediate plans
breaking
for
news.
A Half-Life 2 Episode 3. No plans for a Portal 3, even though that's the one that interests me the most.
Yeah.
Because Portal 2 was supposed to be longer and had an extra mechanic.
Oh.
But it went against the Portal mechanics so much that they pulled it out because it was confusing. People wanted to use portals in these puzzles, and like portals had been taken away for this mechanic.
Oh,
we don't know what the mechanic is. But if it sounds that fascinating, then where's that going? But he says there's going to be a new game in the Half-Life universe, which technically Portal is. It's set in the Half-Life universe.
Okay. Yeah.
There's like mentions of Black Mesa and other things in Half-Life. It's the same universe.
Yeah.
So there's going to be a third spin-off. A second spin-off, but a third series.
Yeah.
In this universe.
okay.
But and so I'm wondering if it's going to be that mechanic, that instead of trying to confuse it with Portal, it's best to separate it and make a third series.
Okay.
Of like, this is all based around Black Mesa and what happened.
Yeah.
The other one is Apisha Science and what happened.
Yeah.
And so there would be, I'm guessing, a third science company.
Yeah, okay, yeah, that would make sense, contextually.
And then that's where the third, this new mechanic, well, hopefully, is where it comes from.
Yeah, yeah.
Because if it sounds so awesome that they built it, Portal 2 around it, and then took it out to save it for later,
yeah,
it must be something awesome.
That's going to be interesting to see.
It must be awesome, because they're not letting us have it.
Yeah. Oh, shit! Too
late! These things are probably one of the things I didn't like most about the game.
Oh yeah, I got panic here.
It's not just the panic, it's once you've killed them, it's sort of an experience that you've had, and it's not a fun one to live again.
Oh, definitely. God, do they get annoying as
exactly
fuck later.
Although I must admit, when you sort of not level up, but the way you level up is by getting better weapons.
Yeah.
Basically, it's their leveling system in this game. When you get the Magnum, and you can take those bastards down with one clean shot, that's fun, I must admit. But yeah, and there's Man Hacks. It's a very uninspired name.
They're called Man Hacks?
I think so.
Huh.
Because that's what I remember seeing them called when I was playing Garry's Mod, which is like a sandbox version of everything in the Source engine.
Yeah.
Oh, shit. Yeah. Yeah, having a flying robot with knives next to a tank of explosive fluid. yeah, that is unnerving.
We're coming up to absolute breaking point where I got stuck.
Okay. How much did you edit out?
I don't think I have edited out in...
Oh, this bit. I remember this being so tedious. This is the bit I think I remember being annoyed at.
Oh.
Because they just keep coming and it's like you're being beaten by something that is way clumsier than you are.
Yeah.
It's like, oh shit, sorry, is that a fence? Oh, is that your arm? Well, I'm aiming for the arm, but oh no, the fence again. It's the artificial intelligence there is questionable.
Definitely.
And the human intelligence on the bit coming up, I'm guessing, is also questionable.
Well, I don't run into fences. So that's something.
My guess with what happened with Half-Life 3, though, is that they built it around VR and then found out that VR makes people sick. Oh, and so didn't want to do it.
I will be, yeah, obviously.
Yeah, this is the fan. First time playing this 2 years ago, I'm nagging about this, but I never, what, I was like, where the fuck do I go? So from this point on, when I finally find the solution accidentally, it's completely new for me. And that does not a well-paced playthrough make.
No. Oh god, I think, I remember now, it's down on the left, isn't it? Basically, it's a hole.
Yeah, somewhere, because...
That you just...
Oh yeah, there it is!
Okay, that wasn't too bad. I mean, it's kind of dark in the water.
Exactly. Kind of dark. That's the worst darkness there is. So, at this point, I was thinking, man, I've had trouble figuring out the puzzles, quote-unquote, so far. What if I don't even have a clue what's coming up? Because I had a vague clue what was coming, but now I have none, so I'm scared and terrified.
No, it's weird. This is the bit, you know, because if you restart this game multiple times over, this is the bit you know the most.
Yeah.
But I'm not remembering this bit as well as I thought. Because I'm now like, where do you go? Oh no, yeah. You follow the pipes.
Probably the other way around. I'm guessing. I don't remember this either. Weirdly
yeah,
enough.
it's a forgettable bit. The really fun stuff's coming up when it gets batshit fun. Because batshit is entertaining, apparently.
the part you're thinking of is definitely coming up with the pipes and ladders.
Oh yes.
Although, it's one. Just.
See, that's fun. I wish they weren't totally synced on the animation there. But I remember, I think I got here and I had very low health for some reason. But I was like really making it through and then got killed on some steam of all things.
The brave hero. Killed by steam.
Killed by the equivalent of a kettle.
It was really hot.
Gordon. What are you doing with that kettle? You'll kill us all. Gordon Freeman.
If you can do that impression and the walking impression back to back.
No. I was thinking about the walking thing over there. I don't know what for. Oh, somebody was talking about Batman Returns. I remember thinking that was a better Batman film. It's really basically Walken is the only good thing in that film.
Yeah.
But then I also thinking about there's two Walkens really that you can do. There's the one where he's doing, what can I call it? The slow and confused Walken.
Yeah.
Where he's explaining something. It's like the story Walken, I think I'll call him. He's not really confused, but
I know what you mean.
He's slow in the way he talks, and it takes him a while to get to some facts.
Yeah.
But then there's the angry Walken that knows exactly where he's going and what he's gonna do. And they sound entirely different.
Oh yeah, that's now that you say it, it's two completely different ones.
But it's like, I mean, he's a better actor than that, obviously. it's just, it's kind of like Brian Blessed. There's only two modes for him, on and off. Do you know who Brian Blessed is?
No. Nope.
Have you ever seen Flash Gordon?
No.
Well, you need to fix that. you've seen Star Wars prequels. Obviously.
Yeah.
Do you? And this is one of his most minor, and he probably doesn't even put it on his CV parts. but you know the King of the Gungans.
Oh yeah, yeah.
That's him.
But he okay, because I that was.
Here's the angry man that shouts everything.
Yeah, but I know this because I looked him up.
Has a large beard.
Yeah, because he kind of looks like him, doesn't he?
No, he's a.
But he played a similar looking character at some point to the Gungan King. in size.
Like the Gungan King is massive. It's just the fact that they're both slightly rotund. Okay, this is the bit that takes
you
forever. Yeah,
this is
forever.
The bit. This, we're going to hear it be a
okay, so
be
now,
a good 10
Brian
minutes.
Blessed is, he's like an old Shakespearean actor.
Uh-huh.
He's done a lot of theatre. But he's just one of those, like, gorgeous British people that you couldn't get from any other land. he doesn't mind swearing about stuff, and he has a life motto that he'll quote a lot in interviews, which is, "Don't let the bastards grind you down!" and he shouts it like that. He once was the host of Have I Got News For You, and it's one of the best. He's famous for shouting a lot of things because of a particular line in Flash Gordon. And everyone thinks he says it in this sort of, "Gordon's alive!" Like this screaming, shouting, booming voice. But he doesn't. He actually holds back on, "Oh my god, you and this ladder. This is, you're glad
from...
I'm getting distracted in this Brian Blessed piece."
There we go.
Yeah, for how long?
Six
how
times.
Long? How long?
Oh yeah,
there you are.
Go down
good
here.
well done. And then it's another 10 minutes of you trying to get back on the bastard.
Okay, don't let my stupidity get in the way of your ass.
He doesn't shout it and scream at that. He says it in a sort of a, "I don't believe it," kind of, "Gordon's alive." And then that's a way you could go. You look at it.
And
I
couldn't
even see you thinking about it.
Yeah, but
and
I tried to jump, but it didn't work.
Okay. I think you can totally just jump up there.
Probably. Guarantee you.
And then here, the bright red turny wheel that you totally miss. You can walk over it, I think. At one
I
point.
Do?
Yeah, there,
oh, there
it is.
Oh, there it is. There it is.
And then,
can I get close to it?
I guess it's kind of out your field of view.
It could have been part of this.
Maybe
scenery.
This whole time, the problem's just been you've got your field of view settings wrong. It's just hiding things out of you.
I think
you do walk over it when you're on one of your... You go up and down here quite a bit. And you stare at it for a small while.
I think I had high FOV. I'm very picky about my field of view. It's rare if I play... an FPS, which I rarely do. If they don't have an FOV slider, it's basically out of the question.
We've been spoiled by things like Bioshock, that anything that you can do glows and has an arrow pointing to
it. Oh, yeah, definitely.
This ain't Daddy's Bioshock game. This is Half-Life 2, bitches.
Where nothing glows.
And then you try random bits of scenery, even though you've walked past a bright red button. And you look at the unit, you try that. Do I have to open that and then do it? Do you have to call the electric board and a guy come out from 9 to 5 Mondays to Fridays,
yep,
depending on how busy things are, and open it for me?
I think you can
then,
make some.
And it turns
of...
out they're on strike, so you got to wait for the unions. No, it's just a button.
I think you could make a scientific study of the human mind by using this video alone.
I think it's what they base the AI for the guys on, isn't it? The bad guys.
They watch people try to do this puzzle. Puzzle, as in
a puzzle.
Finding
it's not
the
a puzzle. This is not a puzzle.
In my world, this is a puzzle.
You resort to just hitting metal with another, and then do you get that? That's it at this point.
I think so. Metal, no
so
break.
So you know the
what now do.
So you know no. You went for it. You stared at it. Or are you going back for it now?
I think I'm going back.
Like, there's even a crate there to give you a fucking clue.
Come on. I see it. I want the crate, though.
Hooray!
Do I even... Yeah, yes. I do it! I'm a genius!
Well, you can even see in your expression of the... Well, then. But now what?
Oh, yeah. I don't...
Still have to do the puzzle bit.
I found the bright
it's not
red
exactly
button.
Taxing level on lemmings, is it? No, you're still waiting for the water to come up.
Yeah.
At least you're not sat there like worrying that you're going to drown.
And what?
Oh, more man hex. I think, and I used to put this on, but there's like an interface thing option. where it will give you a little notification every time you kill something. A bit like when you're in multiplay. Multiplay.
Okay.
Jesus, I am showing my age. when you're in...
Yeah, that's single multiplay in my day.
Yeah.
Just several.
Yeah, you can only play once, but multiple times. What? I don't know. Yes, when you play deathmatch is the word I was scrambling around my brain for. Deathmatch, do you like get a notification of who killed you when? I think you can like say, you killed a manhack. And so you learn what all the villains are called that way.
Oh, okay.
It's just a light bulb, Marcus. You can proceed.
Right, light.
But it's red.
I must press it.
It's like one of my favorite.
Oxygen.
It's one of my Oh god, you don't die, do you? Oh my god. No. No.
Oh, thank god.
It's like one of my favorite jokes from. Have you ever seen Red Dwarf?
No.
Okay, it's like a sci-fi sitcom. And it's people a bit like Lost in Space sitcom with one human, a hologram, a cat that has evolved over thousands of years of the guy being in frozen in stasis. His cat evolves on the ship while nobody else is there and evolves into a human-like creature with six nipples.
okay.
Plus, what's the other thing? It's him, a hologram. Oh, and then a robot android thing joins them eventually, and they become this ragtag bunch of assholes going through space. but they upgrade the ship to be more battle ready, and so they're pretending to be like they're playing Star Trek almost in this episode.
Uh-huh.
And the guy who thinks he's captain says, "Okay, enemies are in sight. Go to red alert." And the robot sort of stares at me going, are you sure, sir? Red alert? Yes, red alert. That does mean changing the bulb. I just love that joke. I don't know why it's one of those jokes that will just never leave me when I'm in like a fucking Alzheimer's state in a bed and I can remember my own name, how to swallow, and that joke. I'll still chuckle to myself. Change the bulb.
And there are a ton of those.
Yeah, they're really, really proud of those, aren't they?
Oh, yeah.
Look, they can move in three dimensions. That... Imagine the AI we had to write for that one.
That didn't take as long as I remember. It felt longer doing that.
I reckon you edited it somewhere where you just stared at the wall for 5 minutes.
Oh, yeah,
there
maybe
wasn't
I
any
did.
Frame.
I
have not noticed the frame jump.
But I think I stared at the wall because I might have looked it up even.
Oh god.
But if that's the case, it's embarrassing. But
it already
unnoticeable.
Is. Now you're just trying to skirt your way around the embarrassment for your own sake.
Oh, I waddle.
Self-preservation.
That...
I say there's these bits I'd remember, but I don't remember enjoying them.
No, it's just...
And I do love this game. I'm saying a lot of nasty things about it, but...
The good parts outshine all the others.
Yeah, like, I remember really enjoying the vehicle parts.
Oh, yeah, that was so fun!
And it's almost a shame I can't piss about in the... Oh, God, why are you back down? Do you have to... Is this the right place to come down? Yes. Okay.
Huh.
I thought that... thought you come back the wrong area.
Probably an accident.
Oh, this is where it does the notification. Don't do that again, asshole. Do it as little as possible.
Oh, those things are... Hey,
vehicles very soon, isn't it? Aren't you?
Yeah, you it's coming up. Coming. Definitely.
You got here at a bad time. I love that bit. Black Mesa East to station got here just in time. Oh, just in time for the cutscene. Nice.
Oh yeah, airboat.
Like, the way he goes, I wanted to ride the airboat. You get the airboat. It just turned up. It's been here 5 minutes, and he gets the airboat. Help yourself to supplies. That's my airboat.
That is one of the most fun vehicles ever to drive. But I think you have to get past the parts.
It's in Gary's mod as well.
Yeah, I can imagine.
You can make like trains out of it. It's awesome. Okay, let's get ready for next time for some airboat action.
Oh yeah.
Chocks away.